Lord Jesus, you shine brightly for all to see. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you open the ears of a man who is deaf. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you raise up all who died in everlasting life in heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen.
See the Lord, glory.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. Haystack. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. Burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
And Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee, to the district of the Decapolis. People brought to him a deaf man with a speech impediment, and bade him lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself away from the crowd, put his finger into the man's ears, and spitting, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, Ephphatha, that is, he opened. Immediately the man's ears were opened, the speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone. The more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, he's done all things well, makes the deaf hear, and the mute speak. The Gospel. Souls are filled with joy because we know the Lord is with us. We know letter of James. James tells us our faith cannot be one of favoritism. So each person, everyone we know, everyone we see, is created in God's image. All of us are God's children, and all of us need to be treated that way. See the face of Christ in every person that we encounter in our daily lives. In the grocery store, in the school, wherever the case may be, see the face of Christ and see the face of Christ in ourselves. We are created in God's image, and so we walk with the Lord in our lives. But we all know this, in our human condition, it can be very easy to judge others, appearances, or whatever the case may be. And also it says in today's reading to show favor to the rich over the poor. So then later on in James it says, did not God choose those who were poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom? Let me say that again. Did not God choose those who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom? When I read this, I thought right away of Guatemala, 2006. I went down there with Bishop Thomas and Al, Bishop Jeff Lending, four or five other priests in the mission, and amazed that people were just living in total poverty. They had shacks for homes, they had dirt floors, and they were the happiest people I ever saw in my life. They were just at the mass, they were filled with big smiles and great joy. And apparently some of those people had walked 14 miles round trip to go and to celebrate mass. But the reason was they were totally dependent on the Lord and their families. That's all they had, and they were the happiest people you ever saw in your lives. So those who are poor in the eyes of the world will be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom. Today's Gospel Mark, so Jesus cures a deaf man who has a speech impediment. So he puts his fingers into the man's ears and spitting touches his tongue. As we know, he says to the man, Ephphatha, be opened. As a man that was free of his illness was able to give the Lord glory. So the Lord says to us tonight, in the year 2024, Ephphatha, be opened. Open our minds and hearts to the power of the Lord in our lives. Open our minds and hearts to the power of the Word of God. As we listen to the Word of God, allow that power of the Word to come deep in our hearts and souls so that it becomes a rock foundation for all of us and people around us. And open our hearts and souls to the power of God's mercy. There is nothing more powerful than the love and mercy of God. But we need to believe that in the depths of our souls. Yesterday's history, tomorrow's mystery, today's present. That's why it's a gift from the Lord. The mercy of God is so powerful for all of us. Open our minds and hearts to surrender to God's will. Just say, Lord, I surrender. What do you want me to do in my life? How can I serve you the best I can to be Christ and bring Christ to the world? And so open our minds and hearts to the power of the Eucharist. Every Mass that we celebrate throughout the world, a miracle, as we know, takes place. It's bread and wine become the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Jesus Christ, truly food for our journey on our pilgrim way, so that Christ comes into our hearts, give us the wisdom and the strength to bring Christ to the world and his joy and his peace that surrounds us. Open our minds and hearts to the love and compassion of others. And tonight we think about a person. I haven't been in touch with this person, I haven't talked to them, or sent them a little letter or whatever. Act on that, because that's the Lord working. You say, hey, you need to talk to somebody, give them a call, but be compassionate to others. Reach out to those that are in need. Maybe somebody in the hospital or somebody that needs to go homebound and needs a visit, take some time for that, because that means, as we know, all of us know, it means the world when somebody reaches out to us in our need or a card or whatever. I got a couple of cards recently, from this thing up here, and I deeply appreciate that. So every act of kindness we do means the world to others. of that. She saw the face of Christ and the poorest of the poor of Calcutta. Just live by that adage. I see the Lord in their lives, and I see the Lord in our own hearts and souls. And so sometimes our doubts and fears can kind of get in the way. But again, just see Christ in ourselves as well. His love and his mercy is with us always. So may the power of love, who is Jesus Christ himself, transform our hearts and lead us to everlasting life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Full welcome in the human community and the church. We pray to the Lord. Brendan Gallagher, for whom our Mass is offered. May they rest in the peace of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Faithful God, who sent your Son into the world to heal the sick and teach the simple, hear our prayers and might listen to the living word of Jesus. May our hearts be transformed by his saving power. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and my God. God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, grace to grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty. By partaking in the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Give some thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, from you we live and move and have our being. While in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the past of history. And so with all the angels, we praise you in some joyful celebration. Supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Story of faith.
Pray upon the oblation of your church. Recognize the sacrifice of victory by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, and that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, filled with this Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Helena, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance peace and salvation of all the world. Please to confirm in faith and charity the Pilgrim Church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and us, and Anthony, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people named for your glory. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you. Your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give time to mix your kingdom, there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, who you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in me, O God Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. place into the world, blessed are those called in the supper of the Lord.
Lord, have mercy on the Lord, and let us say the word, and our soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
because he first loved us, and we are made together by the prayers and the news. The Lord,
my God, teach my heart to say, where am I to see you? Where am I to find you? You have made me and you have made me, and you have still done me all the good things I possess, and still I do not know you. I have not done that which I was trying to see. Teach me to see you, for I cannot see you unless you teach me, or find you unless you show yourself to me. Let me see you when I desire, and let me desire you to listen to me. Let me find you by loving you, and let me love you when I find you.
Lord be with you.